Okay, everyone, this is gonna be a quick one, I promise. Think about this, right? You got all these guys doing YouTube videos talking about South is really North, North is really South. What was the other one they were doing? Oh, Jerusalem is in South Africa. Now this is my rebuttal to those things, right? And I know I don't have to, but it's just something I wanted to put out there to see what you guys think. We have all these old wise tales, right? That tell us how to find north. Not only that, but as I was watching a gentleman explain the red star, that the red star is the North Star. It's on the California map, right? And true north, it always points true north or whatever. That's how you can find it. I forget, there's another name for it. That's what I'm trying to think of. There's another name for it, but it's slipping my mind. But it's always going to be in the north, right? There's another one I was thinking about. We were always taught that moss grows on the north side of a tree, right? So if, you know, north is really south, south is really north, how come these things have been passed down to us by, you know, those that came before us? See what I'm saying? So to me, I look at those things and I hold those things as being, you know, true, more than worrying about flat maps flipping. But the other thing was this, you know, Jerusalem being in South Africa. All right. So I thought about this, right? And this was the obvious one. The other one about the whole north and stuff like that. I've seen it on the History Channel where they talk about the shift, the poles shifting and stuff like that. So I know where, you know, some of that also can come true. But the South Africa being Jerusalem, I thought about this, all right? The Lemba people, when you go back and watch the documentaries, look where they're located. They're located in South Africa below Ethiopia. I know it's directly below Ethiopia. I'm not really good on the name of the place, but I remember when you're watching the video, they show you that they're at least there along that, you know, the tip there and along the coast of South Africa. And I'm thinking to myself, if they were, you know, genetically tested and their, you know, DNA matched the bones found in Palestine, then why were they so easily ready to go to Palestine and participate in the Jewish customs there? Why didn't they say, no, we're good, you know, we know where we're at, we know what we're waiting for, that kind of thing. I'm sorry about the Nike logo. It's weather's changed and I'm freezing, so I haven't got a winter coat until quite some time. I'll get one coming, but sorry about that. Didn't mean to be distracting, but I was just thinking about that. Why would they easily, you know, leave there? I mean, I know they're going back now, back to the where they were located, the ones that left because they're being so mistreated in Palestine. Shocker, right? The Babylonians version of racism still exists because of their teachings and what they believe and how they've switched everything up. But that's what I thought about. They were so close to it. How come they didn't know? They've had the customs and the practices. How come they wouldn't know that it's there, right? So this is just something I wanted to see what you guys think. All right, so take care, everybody. We're going to pop out some more.